Hi, beautiful angels. This is Mystic C from Magic Wands Tarot, and this is your most awaited love and work forecast for October for Taurus. Yes, friends, if your sun sign, moon sign, rising sign is in Taurus, this reading is for you. If you know a Taurus, you can cross watch it for them. Make sure to subscribe, like, and share Magic Wands Tarot. Join us on Instagram. To buy a personal reading, visit our website as shown on the video, www.magicwandstarot.com, friends. And you can buy your own personal 2022 readings from the website. They are very detailed, super accurate. And those who bought it in 2020, they were completely shocked because we did mention what will happen. So yes, and those who got it for 2021 were even more shocked because so please plan, you know, you will know everything of what will happen ahead. So please book yours now, friends. They are very detailed, they take a lot of my time, so book yours, and they are super super helpful, especially in the crazy times we are right now in. So, Taurus, this reading may resonate with you or it may not. So, take whatever resonates. The Hindi Urdu versions of these readings are in the timestamps. So, check that out. Let us see what is the theme of the month of October for Taurus. Let's see that. Taurus, what is the theme of the month of October? All right, Nine of Wands, Four of Cups. All right. So, So October is a slow month for you, friends. It feels like you are starting October. There is a sense of dissatisfaction. Like you feel there is no meaning in life. There is no purpose in life. You are a little, how do I say this? Life is okay, but you are finding it nothing interesting. So it is, you can say it's a boring month in easier terms, or you may feel like, nah, nothing interests me, nothing excites me. That kind of a month it is, like slow, you know, like languid summer months, you know, where the summer is long and the days are long and the nights are even longer, and you are like, nah, nothing exciting happening. So you may feel a little bored this month. Also, you should not give up. You know, you may feel you are disinterested in a few of your dreams and goals and messages, but you should not give up, friends. Yes, absolutely, Taurus. You may feel bored of your work or your love life, but you should not give up, because you know you are about to have a victory. So victory is coming if you persist. Your persistence is the key in this month, Taurus. If you persist, you will have a chance of a lifetime, a love of a lifetime, or the job of a lifetime, you know. And if you have to keep on going, even if you do not feel excited this month about your dreams, about your job, about your work, about your love life, keep on going, keep doing the things which are necessary, because from there you will find happiness and you will find success. I also feel for some of you, what is missing in life is love. What you are trying to figure out, what is missing in my life, it is actually a love relationship, somebody to love, somebody to hold, somebody to, you know, kiss and, you know, just be there for you, you know. I think, Taurus, you are missing that. You should not give up. If you are really single, you should not give up. This month you will find what you are looking for if you stick, if you persist. Persistence is the key, Taurus. So please, do not give up on your dreams. This is a very powerful month. You will have what you are seeking if you persist. Yes, new excitement is going to come your way, and you are going to find this excitement, Taurus. So please do not give up. You may start the month feeling like, it's so boring, I don't like it. But if you stick by, you will find some exciting love, some exciting work opportunities, and even some competition which will challenge you, and you will feel like, I'm liking this life now. So keep on, Taurus, keep on going. Let's see your love life. The higher high priest, okay. Lots of cards want to come out. The emperor, the eight of cups, the ten of swords, the queen of swords, the high priestess, the two of pentacles, the five of wands, the knight of pentacles, the six of cups, four of swords, the Knight of Wands, the Moon, the Hanged Man, and the Page of Pentacles. So first thing I'm feeling, Taurus, is you have options in love in the month of October. If you are fed up of your current partner, if you're just like, I'm stuck, this person doesn't say anything, I need a change. Yes, you will find some changes. Good news, options are coming to you. Firstly, I feel like someone, you are recovering from in the first week, you are recovering from a heartbreak. You are recovering from a past loss. I feel someone has left you or you walked out of a relationship. But you still miss that person. That person is very arrogant. I'm sorry to say, Taurus, they could be a little snob, snobby. They are a little like, I am the boss, who are you kind of a person. I do feel they also miss you right now in the first week, but they are not telling you. And you may feel like this person is just not ethical in some way. Also, you may feel like the differences between you are for because of the gender or, religion, culture, gender, long distance relationships are causing a problem in your love life. So all those, bigger things are on your mind in the first week. Like, you may feel your person is a little obsessive. You may feel your person is a little aggressive. You may find them a snob. You may feel like this person is not ethical. We are not even meant to be together. All these thoughts are in your mind. I don't know what you did, Doris, but in the first week, someone is also missing you and they want you back, but they are not telling you this. They could be married or they could be from a different religion, culture, and you may be like, see, we can't marry each other, so why date? Why waste our time? So there are some ethical issues here, some big questions on your mind. So let's see the second week. Oh my God, in the second week, definitely you will be very, very busy. There is a lot on your mind, Taurus. You are thinking a lot. I also feel that someone will be messaging you, but you will not feel very open to them. It will be an Aquarius, Libra, Gemini person. I also feel your lover may try to reach out to you from social media or through emails or through text messages, but you are like, I'm busy. I don't know what to do. So you may feel, a little preoccupied, a bit little busy, and the High Priestess. I do feel, friends, that you must listen to your intuition, Taurus, in the second week, because it is very necessary. Someone who left you is coming back. They are trying to be extra sweet, extra nice, but it is up to you to listen to your intuition and see if you want them back or if you want to move on. But if you listen to your intuition, you will know the right answers. Also, even if the person is not messaging you, you will feel very connected to this person telepathically. You will feel their thoughts, hear their messages. So you are like, why is this person still affecting me even though they are not messaging me? So let's see the third week. Wow, in the third week, you can expect some debates, you can expect some conflict. Also, you and your partner may feel differently about things. There may be a difference of opinion. I also feel you have to take this week slowly. If you hurry too much if you make quick decisions, Taurus, it will not go your way. The slower you are, the steadier your relationships will be in the third week. A soulmate, yes, your past person is back. They love you. They miss you. Your relationships have a very sweet quality in them, a fondness and affection. Love is back. Romance is back in the third week. But you will still be, some of you may even go on a picnic or a holiday with your lover, your husband, wife. You will be spending some quality time with them, some romantic time. You will enjoy it, but still you will be like, we don't think alike. There is a certain difference between you and them. So let's see the fourth week. Wow. In the fourth week, things are again stuck in your love life. You may feel like your person is, you may feel like your person is very headstrong, like you did in the first week. Like, they are aggressive, they are headstrong, they don't listen, they are bossy. You may advise your person something, but they may reject it. I also feel the fourth week is going to be a very emotional time for you, Taurus. So be careful. Try not to push things a lot. Aries, Leo, Sag, I do feel you may have a choice in lovers between an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius and an Aquarius, Libra, Gemini person. So some of you may be like, you want somebody new and you may move out in the fourth week. For others of you, you will have to control your emotions in the fourth week and, balance your heart and your mind regarding this lover. because your heart says you love them, your mind says this is not the right thing to do, this is risky, they are bossy, they are selfish, what am I doing? So you have to figure it out in the fourth week what you need to do, Taurus. So let's check some advice, because I think you're gonna need some advice in your love life and your work and career. All right, Taurus, what is how your, you know, advice for Taurus love life? Okay, truth, yes, you have to be very practical, Taurus, in this month, because you know you have a choice. Life may be boring, but are you accepting somebody just because out of boredom? Or you know, if you know, you may have choices. You have to be really practical and honest about your love life. Also, opening your heart, you have to open your heart. Are you being scared? Are you being scared of hurt, so you don't open your heart? Obstacles and challenges, yes, there will be certain delays in your love life, Taurus, but it is to make you come closer to your heart chakra, to bring your relationships to truth, honesty and ultimate romance. So keep, don't give up, keep moving forward. If you don't give up, persistence is the key. If you don't give up, you will find a lot of love. So let's see your work and career for Taurus. The crown chakra, okay, transformation, recognition, patience, yeah, persistence and patience is the key. Okay, Taurus, so in October I see that some of you could be changing your jobs, changing your careers, changing where you are working. You may be changing or shifting to a new job. Some of you may also be relocating because you are done with some place or some situation. You are like, I'm done living here. I want to shift. I want to I want to shift. I want to change. I want to relocate, and that will happen. But I see that any decisions you take in the month of October for your work or for your studies, you should think them carefully, because any change you make in October will affect you for the long term. So don't make quick, hasty or impulsive decisions. I also feel that, you know, some of you might be changing your life purposes, like you are connecting, you feel guided to write a book, so you will do that. You feel connected to, you know, go into fashion designing or jewelry or makeup, and you will start doing it because, you know, you have your intuition is guiding you. You have a lot of ideas. You should act and listen on those ideas, and because it will bring you a lot of success. It will bring you a lot of rewards, recognition, fame, money. If you are a student, if you are a student, I see you being successful. I see that you will actually, you know, your life is about to change in October, or by the time next year starts, your life will be changed. Why? Because you are changing as a student. Your thoughts are changing. Your perceptions are changing. But through all these changes in your life purpose and your career, Taurus, you must stay patient. That's one thing you need to do. Keep your patience. I know it is tough, but your hard work is going to pay off. The more the persistence you have shown, the hard work you have shown, it will bring you money, it will bring you fame, it will bring you rewards and recognition. And you may need to change certain things, like not to worry too much. Some of you may relocate, some of you may change your schedule, like everyday routine. Some of you may start start working on a hobby with a job, or you might start working on two jobs, so you are like, I'm doing more, I'm enjoying, I'm having fun. So don't worry. Let's see what else advice for you, Taurus. Let's see. Manifestations, wonderful. You can manifest what you want, Taurus, so do not give up. You are very, very close to achieving success. Do not give up. Also, you can manifest whatever you want in your love life or in your life. I do see, if you want a new job or a better work opportunity, they are coming. You can manifest them. Romance and connections, yes, relationships are a theme for you this month. Love is coming. You have to find your excitement, and I think you are bored because you need love, or you need somebody to love you. So if you know, some sort of an excitement is that for some of you, I think for most of you, you want excitement in the form of love, like somebody who loves you, cares for you, and to open your heart. So, you know, manifest, you will be able to achieve it. And blessings, yes, money is also coming, friends. If some of you were like, where is the money part? Where is my money? Yes, it is coming. Don't worry. You can manifest it. All right, let's see. So earth signs are dealing with a lot of romance in the month of October. That's a good thing. And I think rest everybody else is dealing with work. All right, let's take them. All right, I dropped a card, but I can't pick it up right now. In the middle of the reading, I have to shut the camera first and then pick it up. Bread. Period of prosperity and abundance. Yes, money is coming your way, friends. Money, prosperity is coming your way. So keep going. Romance celebration or a party of fans. Yeah, some of you may be finding fans, people who are really, you know, adore you. Maybe some of you are getting famous. Waiting for news, a package or a letter. Yes, some of you are going to get a package, a celebration, a letter. And unsettled, unsuccessful outcome of a problem, broken bridge. Yes, certain relationships might not be working out right now, but please persist. June is also important. Cain, pay attention to your health. Yes, I do feel, friends, you need to pay attention to your health. Sleep well, eat well, and drink properly. Otherwise, you can affect your health, friends. Someone is leaving your life. Yes, some of you may feel like, you know, you want to leave a partner or a friendship behind and move to a new partner. And I think it will bring an exciting change in your life. Like, some of you may also want to leave a city or a country or a job, you know, and relocate. Boat, money, prosperity through an inheritance or winning a windfall is coming. Oh wow, four leaf clover, great good fortune. So my god, you are going to be very, very fortunate, Taurus. You feel something is lacking in your life, perhaps love, money or goals. Barrel, exactly how you are feeling. I told you something is missing. What is missing? I don't know what is missing. It is your energy, like something is missing, but what is missing? I can't find out. I know something is wrong, but where is it wrong? Everything is good. I have a job, I have a love life, I have good family, I have good friends, but what is missing then? You will figure it out in October, friends, don't worry. Carrot, opportunities and windfall. So I see a lot of money, a lot of opportunities coming your way. And November, yes, November, October are a team month for you, friends. So don't worry if something doesn't happen now, it will happen in November. Do not back down from oppositions, lose strength and fortitude. So keep on moving forward, friends. Do not give up. This is not a month to give up. This is a month to charge ahead, and persistency is your key. Taurus, subscribe, like and share Magic Wednesday. Join us on Instagram to buy a personal reading. Visit our website. This is Mystic C saying bye-bye.